To shot or not to shot? That is the question. And what's up with this picture right here? Hi everybody, Dr. Jordan Wagner here. This week, the COVID-19 vaccine rolled out across the nation. Check out this video of me getting the vaccine, and even look at this nurse just sneak attacking my arm.
All right. Hey everybody, Dr. Jordan Wagner here. At the hospital, gonna get my Pfizer vaccine today. I'm gonna follow up this video to let you guys know. No problem. Make sure you take a look at the other videos that I've made on the vaccine if you have questions. And I'll follow this up just to let you guys know if I have any side effects and kind of go through that journey. Thanks for watching, everybody.
That video was from 2 days ago. I wanted to give it a couple days to see if I developed any side effects. I haven't had any except for maybe a little bit of soreness to my arm, but that's to be expected with any vaccination or injection into your arm. They say that the symptoms might be a little bit more mild to severe coming after the booster. So the booster for the vaccine I got, which was Pfizer, is in 3 weeks from the day that I got the vaccination. And the Moderna one, which just came out for next week, is 4 weeks from the day that you get the injection. In addition to me getting the vaccine, I wanted to do a quick video on the updates of the COVID-19 vaccination as new information continues to come out every single day about it. I got the Pfizer vaccine, but this week the FDA just approved for emergency use the Moderna vaccine, which again is an mRNA vaccine just like Pfizer. Moderna this week is rolling out their vaccine and will have about 6 million vaccinations for everyone. And they say by the end of the year, they'll have 20 million doses. Who's getting the vaccine? It's coming out in waves based on how much the vaccine we have to distribute. And the first people that are getting it are high risk of exposure people, as well as high risk of mortality. So that includes healthcare workers on the front lines, and then elderly population who could succumb to the virus if they get it. Also to be aware, people have asked me many times about kids. They haven't tested it below the age of 16, so that's to come in the future. So nobody right now under the age of 16 can get vaccinated. And then another population that we watch out for are pregnant women, lactating women, and then immune compromised individuals. Right now, it is not recommended for those populations to get the vaccine. So like I said, the first wave are for people who are high risk, like myself, who work in the front lines with COVID-19, and those individuals who are high risk for dying from COVID-19. Next vaccine update, let's talk about allergic reactions. You may have seen on the news in the United Kingdom that two individuals, after they got the vaccine, they had an allergic reaction pretty quickly. They were treated with the standard of care and are doing well now. But we also noticed in Alaska, three people had a similar experience again where they had an allergic reaction and were treated. So the recommendation is that if you've ever had an allergic reaction to a vaccine in the past, they say do not get the COVID-19 vaccine right now. I've had a lot of people send me this photo telling me that this person's not getting the vaccine. These needles have safety covers on them to protect the needle so it flips right over. So there will be a cover near any needle on a syringe. That's normal. And the orange is very specific to a 30-gauge needle that we use to inject vaccinations with. So people are asking me if the cap's on. No, the cap is not on. It's sitting right next to it. That way, right when you're done injecting, the needle's not exposed and you stab yourself. You can flip it right over, and you protect the needle from everybody, and you can dispose of it in the sharps container. If you have any other pictures you want me to take a look at, send them my way. Last update is based on a question I've been getting from a lot of my friends and colleagues that they noticed on the news that there's extra vaccine in these vials. Well, that's common actually, and that's standard practice, because just like molasses in a jar or honey in a jar, when you pour it out, a lot of it sticks to the side. That's the same for liquid medications that we use as well as vaccines. They can stick a little bit to the side. So if you put the exact volume dose that you need into that container, when you go to pull it out, you may not get that exact volume back. So they need to put some extra in to make sure they cover the basis of how many doses should be in there. Another update to be aware of is the number of cases and the number of deaths. Nobody likes to talk about this, but globally, the number of positive cases of COVID-19 surpassed 70 million cases. And the number of deaths right now on December 19th, 2020, is 1.6 million people have died because of COVID-19. That's a quick update with me, Dr. Jordan Wagner, on the COVID-19 vaccine. If you have any questions, comments, concerns about the vaccine, please write me a comment so I can address your questions. And as always, hit the subscribe button and turn the bell notifications on. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.